going, mijo?
Art 101 with Mr. Burger.
Hello, friends. Welcome back to another episode of Art 101 with me, Mr. Burger, a professional artist attempting to bring you the best in art historical content.
I could use someone like you.
Now, as always, I appreciate the likes, the shares, subscribes, comments. Keep them coming. Thank you.
Yeah, that's right. I'm bad.
Now, what do I know? I color for a living, but I know something about burgers. And when it comes to Rodin, we're going to talk about the burgers of Calais. In 1884, Rodin was commissioned to create the burgers of Calais by the city of Calais, France. This work is a tribute to the six heroes of the Battle of Calais during the Hundred Years' War. This Hundred Years' War began, more or less, when the King of France dies and Edward III of England was in line to become the next king. But instead, France chose Philip VI. To become the king. Edward was perturbed by this notion, but he was satisfied with the knowledge that he kept control of a profitable wine region located in France. Everybody was on good terms until Philip let David of Scotland, who was at war with England, have safety inside of his region in France. Shortly after this, one of Philip's trusted allies forged some documents to gain some inheritance money, and Philip wanted him to be put into prison. Playing this little tit-for-tat game, Edward let Robert into England, where he was honored and named the Earl of Richmond. This would give Philip an excuse to reclaim this land held by England and restore his buddy David as the King of Scotland. England would send forces across the English Channel, burn and plunder towns, and do virtually anything to secure territories. The forces were moving north toward their allies in Flanders.
Buenos dias, neighboritos. The handle's Flanders, but my friends call me Ned.
In a little city that was the perfect location because it had a nice port that they could use and it could become a base for their occupations. So picture it, it was September the 4th, 1346. England would attack the double-moated and walled city that sat in the middle of a marsh. Calais had its food and water supplies completely cut off, and the people were starving to death. These people were eating animals that they found in the city and had no fresh water. English forces would attempt to scale the walls and catapult boulders across the wall, but would find no success in penetrating this very big, walled, moated city. After 11 months, the city was near to the point of death. The town had burned all of its military posts, and they would ask Edward for his terms for their surrender. At first, he had nothing.
Free! I hate your guts, and that's what's gonna be left all over the mat!
Eventually, he felt a little more generous toward their lives, and said he would spare the rest of the people if six prominent citizens, called burgers, offered themselves as a sacrifice, along with the key to the city gates. This was agreed to 1 week short of a year from the starting point of the Battle of Calais. These well-off and respected burghers were required to dress in robes, wearing nooses around their necks, and produce the keys before being executed for the good of the city. The men were Eustache, Pierre, Jean d'Aire, Jean de Fenis, Jacques, and Andrew would exit from their homes to die so everyone else could live. The king had full intention to kill them all, but the queen accompanied him, and she felt that it would be bad luck for their unborn child if he went through with this. This child would go on to become Edward the Black Prince.
The Black Knight always triumphs! Hammer Joe!
So the king handed over all six men to the queen, who gave them clothes and food before setting them free. The city would become an English colony for the next 200 years, and in January of 1558, it was returned to France. So now we fast forward to 1884. Calais was in search of an artist to make this memorial, and Rodin was obviously selected for this unique project. Typically, we see memorials for heroes that are victorious, but in this case, we are memorializing the losers who would be granted their freedom. The people of Calais originally wanted for one man to be represented, the primary leader of the group of six, Eustache de Saint-Péri. But after reading the story of these men in the Chronicles, a four-book history based on eyewitness accounts of the Hundred Years' War from 1322 until 1400, Rodin felt that all six men needed to be represented in this memorial. Rodin would be commissioned to do the work for 30,000 francs, 15,000 for himself, 15,000 for the cost of casting. He would make drawings, casts, and small models in plaster, clay, and bronze. I'm an Iowa corn cob. What do I know about big metropolis cities? I didn't grow up in Paris, New York, Los Angeles. I didn't grow up in some big fancy European mecca for enlightenment and art and culture. I grew up in the Des Moines area. But even in Des Moines, we've got some Rodin.
You know, this could be a really positive experience for you guys.
So I'm here at the Des Moines Art Center, and one of the great pieces that they have in their private collection here is a Rodin. Let's go on inside and take a look.
The first step in this process was creating life-size nude figures that clothing would be placed onto to see how the cloth would fall on their bodies in just such a position. This particular sculpture is one of those very first castings that was created as a nude study for the Burghers of Calais. The clothing would have been placed on before it was recreated and recast as it is today.
And Rodin would say, "The important thing for me is the quality, and I think that it is better to do it properly than to rush, because statues remain." The city really wanted something that conveyed satisfaction of service, but Rodin would give them pain and despair. The bank that had loaned the $30,000 for the project had gone bankrupt, so he wasn't getting paid for the project and just finished it however he wanted. And this passion project was bringing in zero income for him, so he would bounce between the gates of hell and the Burghers of Calais. The work would be finished on December the 17th, 1888. The final cast product would be delivered to Calais on May the 28th, 1895.
The government of Calais wanted this sculpture to be placed onto a large pedestal, but Rodin felt that the burghers should be at ground level, not on a pedestal, but just like everyone else, on the ground.
Ah yes, I love that story.